We have another common condition here today, which is alopecia areata. It is actually in a skin autoimmune condition where, which has actually a similar, you know, pathogenesis to vitiligo. It shares certain pathways and treatment pathways where the inflammatory cells or immune cells, instead of swarming the pigment-making cells, it swarms the hair follicle. And so the scenario is that one day patients just wake up out of the blue and they have a circular patch of hair loss that's, you know, bald as a baby's butt. It's very temporary. It is not a scarring alopecia. So treatments are, the condition is receptive to treatment. Our first line treatments in adults is we inject a little bit of steroid in the area so we can shoo away all those immune cells that are targeting those hair follicles. When the hair grows back, the hair can grow back white or gray initially, and then it will most times turn back to the person's natural hair color, but it's possible that it can can stay blonde or white. And it's possible she might have had a larger patch right here at some point in time, but right here all we can see that complete little bald spot. So what we're going to do today is inject it with a small little amount of steroid, and then if it were a larger patch, I would have the patient return next month so we can inject it again. But it's such a small patch, and we already have a 3-month follow-up. I think she'll be fine and she'll have some new regrowth just with one treatment. But if that turns out not to be the case, then she'll make an appointment for a month instead of her 3-month follow-up, and we can re-inject it. And so just quick, easy, and 1, 2, 3, poke. And that's it. All right. Thanks again, guys. I want to thank our patient for being a good sport and allowing us to teach everyone. And I'll see you in a few months.
Yes, sounds good. Thank you.